It's just 9:30 in the morning now. I've been just doing a few little sketches. I'm like obsessed with like drawing circles and drawing stuff in them. So like there's a zombie there, almost like in a like a goldfish bowl or something, you know, with the bubbles and that. And I'm thinking like a green background, something like green fluid or something, holding the head of a zombie. Something similar there, but like a demon brain or of some sort, that I've sketched out really loosely. Same with bubbles and things like that. And this one was more of like a skeleton demon thing, I don't know. But I wanted to do like all rotten, like melting bits in there between, you know, and slime and other stuff. And yeah. So that was just a like 20-minute drawing, you know, just a quick sketch over a cup of tea. So I don't know, I may ink these, I may not, I might draw something different, but I'm thinking of doing something different this week. Bit of painting here and there and other bits. I want to get doing that art board sculpture that I was going to do the other week, but I never got to. Yeah. I think, you know, remember that drawing board that, not a drawing board, like a notice board that I wrote all the videos that I'm gonna do. I think it's pretty pointless me writing and planning things because things change. And yeah. So I think whatever happens, happens. I just come up with whatever. No, plan nothing and just see what I can come up with. I think that's the best way of working with things. I still haven't done them other videos that I still need to do. Bit of editing and things like that, but they're really long videos, so I'm sort of dreading the upload time it's going to take. But I want to finish them as well, so yeah. Following on from what I said yesterday is that I've got to try and, you know, most of the drawings that I've done, I want to like try and simplify, you know, decent drawings and stuff that can be included in this coloring book, because I definitely want to get that out of the way, get one coloring book out of the way at least. So I'm going to go through a lot of my older drawings and try and maybe simplify the lines and maybe make them more like line drawings so they can easily be colored, and maybe add stuff to them and, you know, include them in this coloring book that I've been on about for a while. That's one thing. I definitely want to try and I've been compiling little clips of video bits that I've been working on my graphic novel. I haven't really done any updates on that, but once I reach maybe about an hour and a half of that, I'm just going to put it all together and include that, because you know, I'm constantly thinking about trying to separate the daily art vlogs from the art videos where I don't, you know, show you what's going on between them. And then when the art videos come out separate to the art vlogs, then you've got like sort of like surprise pieces of artwork that you don't know. Well, you obviously know that I've been working on the thing and a few dead space pieces of artwork for a long time. A few good few weeks now, month, maybe a month. But I want to try and keep them separate, and then I don't like confuse the, you know, sort of pieces of artwork with what I'm working on currently, if you know what I mean. Then hopefully I can get these videos out. Yeah, so yeah, let's get on with drawing. So definitely a future project that I've been thinking about. I bought this today, a pack of normal playing cards. Now I thought about painting on each one. You know, just painting over. Maybe like do like a square thing, or keep the, you know, letters and maybe paint something over there, over this, you know, the actual square thing there on most of the other cards, you know, the, and just maybe make an original sort of deck of cards. These are only cheap playing cards, but I think it's something to think about. Or I could just paint off the whole card, and then I'd just like keep the back, which is like normal standard cards. I don't know. Or I could just paint the back. I don't know. I could do either one. Either one, or paint anything on it. But I think I'd have to stick to a theme. And you know, so there'll be like 52 cards here. Yeah. So it's just an idea. It's one of many projects that I could do. It should take quite a bit of time to do that. So, and time is not something that I can figure out at the moment. but yeah, that's hopefully a future project. If I get on with that, you'll probably see like updates here on YouTube or Instagram and Facebook, you know, little bits here and there. So yeah, I just thought I'd show you that one possible project coming up in the future. I don't know when. You know me, I'll probably just say that I'm probably never get on with anything, but yeah. So I thought I'd add some colour to these with some light watercolours before I ink them, but I'm going to focus on this one. So like I said, I wanted the outside to be green, so it's like it's in like a massive bubble tank or something, glass tank or something like that. So I'm going to use a bit of green watercolour. I've just watered down watercolour. Yeah, that's the type of colour I want. Really light. Just water it down. To get some more, and then just keep watering it down all the time. More water. Spread it out a bit. So yeah, usually I ink stuff first. I keep forgetting about the back. Keeps absorbing some of this shit. A loose green colour. Put that there a minute. I'll just use another piece of that just behind it. That's maybe a good idea not to like splatter paint on your drawing board to stop all them shit there, because you're working on a piece of art, you just get like little speckles and stuff like that. Right, just wash the brush a bit more. Don't want any green or anything on it. I'm just going to give this zombie head like a little base coat of this light brown. I need it real watery, just like, you know, that. Yeah, that'll do. Spread it around a bit. The good thing about this is I can see the pencil lines underneath, as long as I don't put too much watercolour on. Spread this around a bit more. Forget the ears. the mouth area there, so I can add other stuff later on. I think it will benefit from a bit of dark green just underneath, a bit more, green. There we go. Give it sort of like a shadow, more of a shadow just underneath. And thin these out a bit more. So I'm going to just wait for that to dry, and then I'm going to wink over that. And it just gives a nice base colour to work from. So I have to find a lot of them lines, but I can faintly just see them underneath there. So I'll just wait for that to dry, just give it a moment. So now that's dry, I can just go in now and start to ink a lot of the lines that was underneath anyway, so I can do that. But don't worry about gaps and things like that, because I can fill in them areas with like a shade of watercolour later on. As long as I can roughly make out exactly what I drew underneath, so I can faintly see the pencil lines. And it'll all come together as a piece of artwork. Different ways of working, so if you get used to working different ways, then you sort of get the confidence to do certain effects, and just like different ways of drawing stuff. So that's why I thought I'd add the colour in and then just go back over this, and then it'll all make sense, and I can add more detail in this inking stage. I can, you know, really start to add a lot of stuff, because these are watercolor, well, waterproof, I mean, pens, ink pens, so they won't like bleed on the page or anything like that, so it's usually quite good. Then we got that there, we got couple of teeth on the bottom, and then we got the jaw coming there. And then the neck there, which we just need to add a bit more colour to it later on, but it's like a severed head. There and hairs. And don't worry about it not making sense right at this point, because there's still more to add. You know, if you're following along with this, trying to do this yourself, just don't worry at the beginnings, because it doesn't look like it's going to work out, but then it does. Does at the end. So you just gotta soldier on, I think, with the drawings and just try and make them work. Draw another tooth there. Maybe another one there. And then the rest is all just like holes in the cheeks, like stretched, ripped flesh or something.
for all like rotten bits under the eyes there, and then we still want the eyes to roll back, you know, into its head, you know, proper zombie features and stuff like that. Then we'll try and draw a rough line of the scalp there, try and contain it a bit more, and maybe draw like a gash on his face, like there, that continues up there, perhaps. More details, such as eyebrows and things. So we've got our rough sort of outline there. There's some more details, just to flesh things out a bit more. Thicker line under the chin there, and the jaw as well, just to help separate it a bit more. Few little bits, entrails, little fleshy bits there. And to emphasize more the darker areas, the mouth and things like that. So yeah, some more other details, and what I can do is I can start to add more colours to this. Copic marker over the top, try to highlight the areas where there is a lot of blood, bloody areas, fleshy bloody areas. Usually around these bits. The blood areas. So I've got like a grey, which is a bit too much on the brush. Just want to try and work on some grey tones with this watercolour. Gradually build up the tones. It doesn't really matter if you do too much of these grey tones, because they fade anyway. I mean, watercolour, it dries like 50% lighter, so it doesn't really matter at this point. little bit of grey in there on the teeth. Maybe do the eyes as well. Give them a grey colour, sort of base coat. Be useful for later on anyway when I'm adding more colour to it. Just try and blend some of these harsh lines. The thing about watercolour is you can just move it around however much you want, as long as the brush is wet. Right, I want to go darker now. Just have to test this in an area, maybe under the eyes. Under there, the frown lines. I can leave that to dry and we can come back to that. Add some more tones and other stuff and coloured pencil work and things like that. So now I'm just going to try and experiment with Copic markers. I've got a sand coloured Copic marker pen, so I really want to try and just work on fleshing out the colours a bit more. The idea is just to make it more browner and rotten looking. And obviously the colour has to reflect, I think, the liquid in the tank, so I'm going to have to put some kind of maybe layer of light green over it at the end. I don't know, we'll see what I can do. I'm just being really experimental with this, to be honest. It's, you know, just trying to build it up. As well, I want to subdue the colour a bit of the red, because it'll be like won't be totally bright red on the blood colours anyway, because it'll be like this liquid sort of is supposed to be like preserving the zombie's head or something to that effect anyway. So so the blood won't be as bright. So that's what I want to do. Yeah, it's blending. It's blending quite nice. Soften them colours how I wanted anyway. Start to use another colour. I really want to try and do like a pink. I don't know if it'll take well. Yeah, I sort of see it on there, but not well, really. not really what go over that, so there's no point trying. I want to get some more pinker areas, particularly over the tongue and that. It's a different colour to that, so just add it in bits and pieces. Maybe a thin layer of pink under the eyes. A bit more over there, over the cuts and stuff. Really, it's just about building up layers and stuff like that. I'm sort of unhappy with the background. Don't know whether to try with a Sharpie marker. Maybe try and get a bit more of that darkness in there that I was talking about. And once you add a Sharpie marker, that will be the time to add coloured pencils over the top. Definitely going to be a bright looking colour. Colourful zombie head. Them out later on with coloured pencils, like I said. Thought I'd add more to the eyes as well with the red, really make them look infected and like rotten. Try and get them like loads of blood there. I can go over that. Another bit that I've forgotten about was the neck, where it's all like severed there. It's best if I go over the areas there. Not any more details that I want. Just keep going over it. It's like loads of layers. Loads of layers to a drawing. I'm liking the colours now. You're getting to see like a lot of the blending tones and things like that. And just add more red to them gums and really make them bloody and flesh coloured. We can tone it back if we go too far with the red. So as you saw earlier on, I toned it back with that brown, that sand colour. It's always a good idea to do that. So yeah, it's going all right. This one, I'll have to charge the camera up so I can complete this. I'll be adding like some coloured pencils to smooth it in, and and don't forget about them bubbles as well. I need to add them. So yeah, I'll need to charge this camera up. So I won't be long. So I've sort of run out of time on this bit. I can continue this tomorrow and that other zombie drawing there. I'll try and do some more coloured pencil work on here. Maybe use the Copic markers and try and blend some colours and overlay some detail on this zombie head. And again, try and draw the bubbles in there on the surrounding that zombie head, like it's in like a bubble of its own sort of thing. I don't know. Yeah, so I'll try and continue these tomorrow, and can't wait to finish that one, but also that one, and then maybe ink them. I don't know. I'll try and
work on a bit of them. And yeah, so I just ran out of time. I'm a bit tired myself today, so had a lot to do, but there we go. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now.